Hello, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Pushkar Ajra, and here we have created a small device. It's a ventilator. A few weeks back, I got a feedback from one of my friends in Italy that they're letting people die because of shortage of ventilators. And then I had a talk with a couple of friends of mine who are surgeons, and they put me through to a few intensivists.
So as per his advice, we are taking care of four major parameters. One is the tidal volume, which is delivered to the body. Then the mixture of oxygen and air, which is precisely controlled, and the PEEP pressure, which keeps the pathways in the lungs open for maximum absorption of oxygen. And the fourth one is excess pressure venting, when there is an excess pressure coming in from the circuit that is vented off, or there is excess back pressure from the lungs, it is also vented off. Well, these features are inbuilt into this ventilator. The best part about this is it was designed from the perspective that India is a country made up of a lot of villages, a lot of small places where there is population concentration. So heaven forbid, but this pandemic, if it reaches those areas, then they wouldn't have electricity. So this thing practically works with only an oxygen cylinder. It doesn't require electrical supply. So this is fully driven by oxygen cylinder. That's one of its major advantages. So it can be used for patient movement in an ambulance or primary healthcare centers in rural areas. If the situation is like what it is in the foreign countries, like in the US or Italy, even in the corridors of hospitals, this can be kept to actually save people. And that is what is the purpose and motive behind this social initiative that we have taken.
I'm Dr. Raj, and I'm here to tell you about the ventilator that has just been created. Team from Maharashtra has just developed ventilator support that can be used for basic life support with the best of the expertise. And the best part about it is it does not require any electricity. It is fully functional on oxygen support. And probably it can be used for the basic of your life support, and can be used for millions of people who the mechanism seems to be working absolutely fine. This can be used in ambulances, carryway passages, and even hospitals. And in times of Corona, I think this is a good initiative by people from Maharashtra to get such a ventilator.
So what is the advantage of this over any other manual resuscitators that we are seeing all over the internet?
Yes, there is a plethora of videos which show this particular bag being pressed by a mechanism, and we can adjust speed and volume, but there is a strange problem. So this is not a linearly adjustable volume, so it's very difficult to adjust the correct volume of air which is delivered to the patient. That's one. And the second most important thing is the mixture of air and oxygen, which we are precisely controlling over here. That is not a possibility with this bag, essentially. So I wouldn't want this bag to be used on myself as a standalone system, as a ventilator for sure.
Is the mixing of oxygen and air, is it variable?
Yes, both of these cylinders can be independently adjusted. So if you want 50% oxygen and say 500 ml air, that's absolutely possible.
What do you think about the manufacturing and scalability? Because right now in this pandemic situation, many parts may not be available. How do you propose to solve that issue?
Well, from the beginning, we did, me and my team, Shivaji here and Dilip here, we have been sitting here and we have done about 14 to 15 iterations of design. So in this 14 to 15 iterations, the main concern was the availability of components. So how many components are available where in the world, and whether they are, we would be able to bring them here, whether this would be scalable to at least make about 10,000-15,000 of the ventilators. That was the question. So this design was finalized keeping in perspective these particular demands. So this is scalable, the components are available and can be easily assembled.
Pushkar, you said it is driven on oxygen. So basically, does it require more oxygen than a normal ventilator?
Well, ideally it should not, because the oxygen which is used to drive these cylinders is sent to the patient. So there is no wastage of fresh oxygen. So whatever oxygen you are giving externally is definitely delivered to the patient. It doesn't get wasted.
What support do you need?
Well, the See, the model is scalable, as in we can make a lot of these in a very short span of time, like 10-15 thousand, 10-15, 30 days to be precise. But an escalated approval can actually be a really good thing while actually making sure this mechanism saves lives. So that would be a very critical point in the development of this product.
So where all can this be used?
Well, it can be used in ICUs and ambulances for intensive patient care, and of course everywhere else, but it can also be used for invasive ventilation as well as non-invasive ventilation, because it can impart BiPAP and CPAP as well.